First of three parts of The Mysteries, performed to a promenade audience by the National Theatre.
Good evening. Good evening. On behalf of Bill Bright and the company, welcome to the Cottage Low at the National Theatre. This is The Mysteries. This is The Nativity. And we'll do a dance for you about there. If you'd like to clap your hands, that'd be grand.
I am gracious and great, God without a beginning. I am maker of made, almighty in me. I am life and way unto wealth winning. I am foremost and first, all's I bid shall it be. My blessing in bliss shall be blending, and harbour from harm shall be hidden. My body in bliss I abiding, enduring without any ending. Since I am maker of made and most high might, and I shall be endless, no is but I, unto my dignity dear shall duly be dight, a bliss all abundant about me, in the which bliss I bid that be here, nine orders of angels full clear, in loving eye lasting to lout me. And mightiest of all, I make most after me. I make thee as master and mirror of my might. I set thee here by me in bliss for to be, and name thee for Lucifer, all bearer of light.
All the mirth that is made is marked in me. The beams of my bright hood are burning so bright and so seemly in sight. Myself I now see. Like a lord am I lifted to live in this life.
friends, it appears. In me is no point to impair. I feel me well favored and fair. My power is passing my peers.
Lord, with a lasting love, we love thee alone. You mightiful maker that marked us and made us and wrought us thus worthily to dwell as thy own, where never feeling of filth may foul us nor fade us. All bliss is abundant about us, the while we are stable in thought, in the worship of him that us wrought, of dread need we never more doubt us.
Oh, what? I am favored and fair and figured full fit. The form of all fairhood upon me is fast. All wealth in my wield is, I wot by my wit. The beams of my brighthood are big with the best. My showing is shimmering and shining. So bigly to bliss am I brought, me needs but annoy me right not. Here shall never pain bring me pining.
With all the wit that we wield, we worship thy will. Thou, glorious God that is ground of all grace, I with steadfast sound let us stand still, Lord, to be fed with the food of thy fair face, in life that is loyal and lasting. Thy dole, Lord, is I daintily dealing, and whoso that food may be feeling, to see thy fair face is not fasting.
Oh, search what? Me beseemeth my beams that are brighter than bright, magnificent, mighty am I by my hound. In heaven shall I set myself full seemly to sight to receive my reverence. To right of renown, I shall be like unto him that is highest on height. Or what? I'm worthy and wise.
How?
All goes down. My beams are so bright to be shitten and shent. I fall to fierce fires through the old firmament. From heaven am I hurled, hurled down on all hands. Help, help, Harrow, helpless. So hot is it here. There was space there so speedily spanned. This is a dungeon of dole in which I am dying. Where are my kindred so comely and clear? Now am I laidliest, alas. The air was so light, my blighted Beelzebub is blackest and blue now. My bale is aye beating and burning, that gars me go growling and gurning. Outright bold, wrecked am I by rue now. Thrust into this fire flung out for the thoughts so speedily spilled, the sooner I'd spoke. I wish not this woe should be wrought. Yah! Woo! Out on ye, Lurdens, ye smore me in smore.
Fantasies fell. They would not me worship that wrought them. Wherefore will my wrath there go with them? And all that me worship shall dwell here, I wis. Since earth is vain void and in murkness doth dwell, I bid in my blessing the angels give light. The murkness doth name up a night. The day do I call this clear light. A firmament I bid appear, and that same shall be named heaven, with planets and with cloud is clear. The sun and moon in fair manner, now greatly gang in your degree, for ye shall set the seasons here, day from day and year from year. The water I will be here, to flow both far and near. The largest part I name, the sea, gathering of waters clear. And in the sea I will begin. Whales all quick in sea will dwell, and other fish to flit with fin, some with scale and some with shell. The land shall foster and forth bring, books emily by me decreed, herbs and fruit to fill and feed. Trees also thereon shall spring, and flowers fair on height to hang, and winging with the wind on high, I bid be fowls full fair to fly. All divers beasts on land I send to breed, and be with bale forth brought, and with the beasts I bid to blend, serpents to be seen unsought, and worms upon their wombs will wend, and woe in earth and worse to naught. And so it shall be kenned, how all is made that ought, beginning, mid, and end. I, with my word, have wrought.
Hello,
To keep this world both more and less, a skillful beast then will I make, after my shape and my likeness, the which to me will worship take. From the simplest part of earth that is here, I shall make man. Rise up, thou earth, in blood and bone, in shape of man, I command thee. A female shalt thou have to fear. Here shall I make of thy left rib. She alone shall be thy dear to keep thee warm through night in crib. Take now here the ghost of life, and receive both your souls of me. Take thou this female to thy wife. Adam and Eve your name shall be. Adam and Eve, this is the place that I have granted you of my grace to have your dwelling in. Herbs, spice, fruit on tree, beasts, fowls, all that ye see shall bow to you herein. This place hight paradise. Here shall your joys begin.
O Lord, loved be thy name. For now is this a joyful aim that thou hast brought us to, full of solace, calm and mirth, herbs, trees, fruit on earth, with spices many one too. Louise, now are we brought both unto rest and rue. We need to tack no thought, but look all well to do.
Loving be to such a lord, to us has given so great reward, to govern both great and small, and may those after his own mind such pleasure and such play to find amongst these mirths all. Here is a joyful sight where we in peace shall dwell. We love thee most of might, great God perpetuel.
Love my name with good intent, and hark to my commandment, my bidding both obey. Of all the fruit in paradise, take ye thereof in your best wise, and let your rate vary. The tree of good and ill, what time thou eatst of this, thou speed thyself to spill and be broke out of bliss.
Alas, Lord, that we should do so ill. Thy blessed bidding we shall fulfill both in thought and in deed. We shall not nigh this tree nor bow, nor yet the fruit that on it grow, therewith our flesh to feed.
We shall do thy bidding, we have no other need. The fruit full still shall hang, Lord, that thou hast forbid.
Here shall you lead your lives with dainties that is dear. Adam and Eve, the wife, my blessing have you here.
Alas! My wits are woes with woe! Ah, Lucifer, why fell thou so? I that was an angel fair and sat so high above the air, now am I waxen black as coal, and ugly, tattered as a fool. What ailed thee, Lucifer, to fall? Wast thou not fairest of angels all, brightest and best and most of love, with God himself that dwells above? Alas, the joy that I was in, have I lost through my sin. But hearken all what I shall say of that love that I have lost for aye. God hath made man with his hand, to have that bliss without an end. If I myself am barred from bliss, I shall mankind do much amiss. I, Lucifer, exiled from light, shall the bliss of mankind blight. By my hound, I'll mar for aye the cleanness of God's lump of clay. To Adam's mate I will me hie. In a worm likeness will I wend. And feign for her a likely lie.
Who's there?
I. A friend.
Of all the fruit that ye see hang in paradise, which eat ye not?
We may have the milk of one, take all that does good thought. Save one tree out is tame, would do harm to nigh it all.
And why that tree that would I wait any more than all other by?
But our Lord God forbid so say. The fruit thereof Adam nor I to nigh it near. And if we did, we both should die, he said, and cease our solace here.
Ah, Eve, to me, take tent. Take heed, and thou shalt hear. What that same matter meant, he moved on thus, my dear. To eat thereof you forfend. I know it well, it was his skill, because he would none other kend those great virtues that longs there till, for wilt thou see, who eats the fruit of good and ill, shall have knowing as well as he.
Why, what can sing art thou that tells this tale to me?
A worm that wots well how that ye may worshipped be.
What worship should we win thereby? To either of us needs it not. We have lordship to make mastery of all things that in earth are wrought.
Woman, away! To great estate ye may be brought if ye shall do as I shall say.
Do as us full lord, that should our God mispay.
Nay, sir, it's no harm for both. Eat it safely ye may, for peril, right? They're none it lies. Worship. And the great winning, for right as God ye shall be wise, and peer to him in all kin thing. Aye, gods shall ye be, of ill and good to have knowing, for a be all's wise as he.
Is this sooth that thou sayest?
Yea. Why, trust thou not me, I would by no kind ways tell out but truth to thee.
Then will I to thy teaching trust, and take this fruit unto our food.
Bite on boldly. Be not abashed, and give Adam some to amend his mood and eke his bliss.
Have you a fruit full good?
Alas, woman, why took thou this? Our Lord commanded us both to tend this tree of his. Thy work will make him wroth. Alas, thou hast done amiss.
Nay, Adam, grieve thee not at it, and thou shalt say the reason why. A worm has done me but to wit, we shall be as gods, thou and I, if that we eat it at this tree. Adam, thereby let not that worship for to get, for we shall be as wise as God that is so great, and thou'st mickle of price. Therefore, eat of this meat.
To eat it would I not eschew. Might I be sure in thy saying?
Bite on boldly, for it is true. We shall be gods and know all things.
To win that name I shall it taste at thy teaching. Alas! What have I done? For shame! Ill counsel! Woe worth thee! I e'en thou art to blame, to this incite thou me.
But it does me shame.
For I am naked, as me think.
Alas, Adam, right so am I.
And for sorrow sore, why might we not sink? For we have grieved God Almighty, that made me man, broken his bidding bitterly, alas, that ever we began. This work Eve hast thou wrought and made this bad bargain.
Nay, Adam, blame me not.
The will of Eve, who then?
The worm to white well worthy were, with pale bum through him he betrayed.
Alas, that I list to thy law, or trust the trifle that thou me said, so may I bid. or I may ban that bitter bread and dreary deed that I it did. I was shaped for dull me greed. Wherewith shall they be hid?
Let us take these fig leaves, since it thus bit it.
Right as thou sayest, so shall it be, for we are naked and all bare. Full wonder fain I would hide me from my lord's sight. If I wist where I not care.
Adam! Adam!
Lord?
Wherefore art thou there?
I hear thee, Lord, and see thee not.
Say, where does it belong, this work? What hast thou wrought?
Lord, Eve made me do wrong unto this breach has brought.
Say, Eve, why hast thou made thy mate eat fruit I bade thee should hang still, and commanded none of it to take?
A worm, Lord, enticed me that till. So, well away, that ever I did that deed so ill.
Ah, wicked worm. Woe worth thee, I, for thou on this manner hast made them much afray. My malice have thou here with all the might I may. And on your wombs then shall ye glide, and be I full of enmity to all mankind on ilka side. And earth it shall your sustenance be to eat and drink. Adam and Eve, also ye, in earth then shall ye sweat and swink and travail for your food.
Alas, when might we sink? We that are all world's good, full grievous may us think.
Now, cherubim, mine angel bright, to middle earth tight, go drive these two.
Already, Lord, as it is right, since thy will is that it be so and thy liking. Adam and Eve, do you two go, for here may ye make no dwelling. Go ye forth, fast up there, of sorrow may ye sing.
Sad. Morning makes me mazed and mad to thinking out what help I had and now has none. On ground may I ne'er go glad. My games are gone. Gone are my games without and glee. Alas, in bliss could we not be. For put we were to great plenty at primate day. By time of noon, all lost had we. So, we'll away.
Back room! Back room!
For Adam, keep not coming here! The worship is!
Stop it!
This ploughman Cain and shepherd Abel, brothers both, have told it fable. With four fine fillies, plough and pack, they laboured long with bended back. Stack tent, 'tis truth I tell to thee.
So stand stone still,
and thou shalt see.
both may and can. Speed thee, brother, and thy man.
Come kiss mine ass, I will not ban. But away from here is your welcome. Thou shouldst have stayed till thou were caught.
But, brother dear, aim I saw. It is the custom of our law that all the workers that are wise shall worship God with sacrifice. Come forth, brother, and let us gang to worship God. We stay too long.
Shall I leave my plough and everything and go with thee to make offering? Nay, thou finds me not so mad. Go to devil and see I bad. For gives God to thee to praise him, so he gives me nought but sorrow and woe.
Cain, leave this vain carping. For God gives thee thy living.
What had I never yet a farthing of him? Here is my hand.
Brother, as our elders gave command, a tithe should we offer with our hand, a tenth of our goods to be burnt with the brand.
Lay down thy bundle upon this hill.
Forsooth, brother, so I will. And God of heaven, take it for good.
Now offer first thy livelihood.
God that shaped both earth and sky, I pray to thee, thou hear my cry. Now, take with thanks, if thy will be, the tithe that I offer here to thee. For I give it with good intent, to thee, my Lord, that all is sent. I burn it now with steadfast thought, in worship of him that all has wrought.
The tithe that I here give to thee of corn and things that grow for me. But up against this is my turn, and I must needs me tenth to burn. One sheep, one. This makes two. Yet neither can I spare for you. Two. Two. Now this is three. Yea, this also shall stay with me, for I will choose the best to have. Ah. This is thy due of all this sheep at last. Four, lo here. Better grew I none this year. At springtime I sold fair corn. Yet it was such when it was shorn. Thistles and briars, yea, great plenty. And all kind of weeds that might be. Four sheep, four. Lo, this makes five. If I deal out thus, I never thrive. Five and six, now this is seven. But this goes never to God in heaven. Nor none of these four from me right shall ever come into God's sight. Seven, seven, now this is eight.
Cain, brother, you call on God's eight.
Nine, ten and two more there, now is all my store. Me help me to blow, it will not burn for me, I trow. This smoke does me much shame. Now burn in the devil's name. What? Oh, what the devil of hell is it? Me lungs almost have been spitted. I've blown in one blast. What have we choked right so? Oh, it stank like the devil in hell. So long as there might I not dwell.
Cain, brother, this is not worth one leak. Thy tithe should burn without this stink.
Come kiss devil right in ass, because of it burns the worse. I would it were in thy throat, firing sheep and every sprout.
Cain, why art thou such a rebel against thy brother Abel? To fly and chide, there is no need. If thou chide right, thou gets thy meed. And be thou sure, if thou chide false, thou shalt be paid with nothing else.
Why, who is that hob over the wall?
Who is that the pipe so small? Come, go, we hence from perils. Oh, God is out of his wit. Come forth, Abel, and let us win. We think the God is not my friend. Away then must I flit.
Ah, Cain, brother, that is ill done. God's will I trow it where that mine did burn so clear.
Why, yea, and thou for that shalt pay. With cheekbone in my hand I stay, till I have torn thy life away. Come lie down there and take thy rest. Thus loud mouths are chastised best.
Vengeance! Vengeance, Lord, I cry! for I am slain and not guilty.
Cain! Cain!
Aye, or is that the cause me I'm here? Mayst thou not see?
Where is thy brother Abel?
Why ask of me? I think in hell I think he be. Him so where they might him see. Or somewhere he may be sleeping. When was he in my keeping?
Cain, thou art wild and mad. The voice of thy brother's blood that thou hast slain in false wise from earth to heaven on vengeance cries. And for thou hast brought thy brother down, here I give thee malediction. Forever plead for death in vain, lest ye be damned, all him disdain.
No matter, I wot whether I shall, and hell I wot must be my stall. It is no use mercy to cry, for if I pray, none must I have. Farewell. When I'm dead, bury me in Wakefield, by Quarryhead. Damn for my deed, I now depart. By all men, said I not a fart.
Don't be an outlaw, don't you be so wayward, have in your own way, when you could be a friend to me, working together, that's what's bound to happen, finding a new way, will you give your hand to me?
Sin is now abroad without any repentance. 600 years and odd have I, without distance, on earth that any sod, lived with great grievance always. And now I wax old, sick, sorry and cold, like muck upon mould I wither away. Yet will I cry for mercy and call, nor thy servant am I, Lord above all. Therefore me and my pride that shall with me fall, save from villainy, and bring to thy hall in heaven, and keep me from sin this world within. Comely king of mankind, I pray thee, hear my saying.
A repentful sore that ever made I man.
By me, he sets no store, and I am his sovereign. I will destroy, therefore, both beast, man, and woman. All shall perish, less and more. Their bargain may they ban that ill did do. On earth I see right naught but sin that is unsought. Of those that well are wrought, find I but a few. Therefore shall I fordo all this middle world with floods that shall flow and roar hideous abroad. As I say, so shall I do. For vengeance draw my sword and make an end of all that bear a life. Save Noah and his wife. For they would never strife with me, nor me offend. Noah, my friend, I thee command from sorrows thee to shield a ship that thou should frame of nail and board full well. Thou always was a good workman. To me as true as steel, to my bidding obedient, friendship shalt thou feel as thy reward. In length thy ship should be 300 cubits, warn I thee, in height even 30 or 50 also broad.
Ah, oh, Benedicite, what art thou that thus tells me before that which shall be? Thou art full marvellous. Tell me, for charity, thy name so gracious.
My name is of dignity, and also full glorious to know. I'm God most mighty.
All right.
One God in Trinity made thee and every man to be. To love me well thou owe. Noah, to thee and thy fry my blessing grant I. Ye shall wax and multiply, and fill the earth again, when all these floods is past and fully gone away.
Lord, homeward will I haste as fast as that I may. My wife will I ask what she wills to say. I'm aghast, we get some afraid, fixed as both. Ooh, she bites sharply. For little's oft angry. If anything wrong be, soon is she wroth. God speed, dear wife. How fares thee?
Now, as ever might I thrive, the worst that I thee see. Do tell me in brief, where hast thou thus long been? To death may we drive, for aught it mean to thee, for want. When we sweat and swink, thou dost just as thou think. But of meat and drink have we real scant.
Life, your heart stayed with tidings and you.
But thou wert worthy be clad in black and blue. For thou art all we are free, be it false or true. God knows that I am treated, and that may I rue, full ill. I trust from thee may borrow, from evening until morrow, thou speak'st ever of sorrow. God grant thee once thy fill. We women must harry all ill husbands. I have one. By Mary that loosed me from me bands, if he be troubled, I must tarry howsoever it stands, with semblance full sorry, and wring both my hands for fear. But still, otherwhile, what we game and we guile, I shall smite and smile, and pay him back dear.
Wait! Hold thy tongue, Ramskies, or I shall thee still!
By my shrift, if thou smite, turn on thee, I will.
Why shall I say as tight? How about thee, Jill? On the bone shall it bite?
Ah! So, Mary, thou smitest ill. But I suppose I shall not in thy death from this floor now flit. Take thee there a langet to tie up thy hose.
Without hope, Mary, that is thine.
One. Thou shall have 3 for 2, I swear by God's pain.
Oh, I shall quite thee then, though, in faith or in sin.
Out upon thee, hard!
Oh, thou canst both fight and whine, and thou roared. For all that she strikes, she will furious strike. In faith, I hold none alike in all middle world. But I will keep charity, for I have much to do.
Here shall no man tarry thee, I pray thee to go. Full well may we miss thee as ever have I rue. To spin will I set me.
Wife, farewell, lo. But wife, Pray for me busily till after I come to thee.
Aye, even as thou prayest for me, as ever might I thrive.
I tarry for long from my work, I trow. Now, my dear, will I bring and thither would draw. Now, say will I what I know of shipwright rhyme. In nomine Patri et Filii et Spiritus Sancti, amen. To begin with this dream, my bones will I bend. I trust that the Trinity succor will tend. This is twice come in, deem on thy friendship.
Whether I lose or win, if faith thy fellowship set I not at a pin, this spindle will I slip upon this hill ere I stir once a foot.
Peter, I trow that we don't, without any more note, come in if he will.
Aye, the water nigh so near that I sit not dry. Into the ship will I flee, and therefore will I hide. For dread that I drown here. Lord, I were at ease and in heart. Oh, might I once have a mess of widow's coal? For thy soul without lie should I deal penny dole, as would more, and no fuss, as I see in this hall, among wives that are here, from the lives that they've led, wish their husbands were dead. Yet as ever eat I bread, so wish I our sire were.
Ye men that have wives, whilst they are young, if you love your own lives, chastise their tongues. Oh, methinks my heart rives and my liver and lung to see such light strifes wedded men among. Now, to my helm will I hint, and to my ship attend.
I see in the firmament, methinks, the seven stars.
This is a great flood. Wife, take heed.
So me thought as I stood. We are in great dread. These waves are so wold.
God help us in our need, as thou art steersman good, and the best as I read of all. Thou rulest in this race, as thou did me promise.
This is a perilous case. Help God when we call.
Oh, the time will come on when the winds will stop and the breeze will cease to be breathing, like a stillness in the wind before the hurricane begins. Ooh, the eye.
40 days has rain been. It will therefore abate, as God did reveal. I am aghast. It has waned a great deal. Oh, the weathers have ceased, and cataracts up knit, both the most and the least.
Living Samowick, the sun shines in the east. Lo, is not yond it? We should have a good feast were these floods split, those spiters.
We have been here all week, 350. Oh, now wanes the sea. Lord, well is us.
What ground may this be?
The hills of Armeni. Dave, therefore thou counsel me. What fowl might best know how, with flight of its wing, to bring without tarrying of mercy some tokening, either from north or from south? It's now the first day of the 10th moon.
Hence, in just a little, she is coming. Bringing in her bill some tidings new. Behold! It is of an olive tree, a branch it seems to me.
Is sooth, birdie, right so it is called. Don't thou bird fully blessed, e'er may thee befall. Thou art true to thy tryst, a stone in a wall. Oh, well it I wish thou'd come back to thy hall.
A true token it. We shall be saved all. For why? The water since she come, of deepness to plumb, is fallen a fathom and more, certainly. And company we knew before.
Dame, all are drowned. Let be thy din, for soon they brought their sins full sore. Good living let us now begin, that we may grieve our God no more. He set his bow clearly to ken, as a token twixt him and us, for knowledge of all Christian men, that since this world was finished thus, with water would ne'er be waste again. Thus has God, most of might, set up his sign full clear. Up in the air in height, the rainbow it is right, as men may see in sight, in seasons of the year.
Abraham am I name, Ed, and patriarch of age full old. Yet by the grace of God is bred in mine old age a child full bold. Isaac Law his name is told, my sweet son that standeth me by. Among all children that walk on ward, a lovelier child is none truly. I thank God with heart full mild of his great mercy and his high grace, but principally for my sweet child, that shall to me do great solace. Now my sweet son, so fair of face, full heartily do I love thee. But you are in love now in this place. My sweet child, come kiss now me.
At your bidding your mouth I kiss. With lowly heart I you pray. Your fatherly love let me never miss. But bless me your child both night and day.
And may no man love better his child than Isaac here is loved to me. Almighty God, merciful and mild, for my sweet son, I worship thee. Thank thee, God, with heart full free, for this fair fruit thou hast me sent. Now, gracious God, wheresoe he be, to save my son evermore be bent. Abraham, my servant Abraham. Lo, Lord, already here I am. Take Isaac, the loved little lamb in whom the heart takes all delight, and cut his throat upon yon height in sacrifice, his blood to spill with sword and fire upon yon hill. Abraham, the son Isaac, must that kill?
Lord, to thee is my intent ever to be obedient. That son that thou to me hast sent, offer I will to thee. My God, Lord, omnipotent, thy bidding, Lord, done shall be. Make thee ready, my dear darling. We must do a little thing. This wood do thou on thy back bring. We may no longer bide. And fire and sword that I will take. The sacrifice me behoves to make. God's bidding I will not forsake, but ever obedient be.
Father, I am ready to do your bidding most meekly. To bear this wood full bound am I as ye commanded me.
Oh, Isaac, my darling dear, my blessing do I give you here. Take up this faggot with good cheer, and on your back it bring. And fire with us I will take.
Your bidding I will not forsake. Father, haste now will I make to fulfill your bidding.
Now, Isaac, son, go we our way. To yonder mount, if that we may. Oh, my heart will break in three. To hear thy words, I have pity. As thou wilt, Lord, so must it be.
But why make you so heavy cheer? Are you out of dread? Father, if it be thy will, where's the beast that we shall kill?
Thereof, son, is none upon this hill that I see here upon this stead.
Father, I'm full sort of fear to see a bear that sharpened knife. I hope by all my tender life you will not slay your child.
Dread thee not, my child, I read. The Lord will send of his Godhead some manner of beast into this field, either tame or wild.
Father, tell me or I go, whether I shall arm or no.
Oh, dear God, that me is woe. How burst my heart in sunder.
Father, tell me of this case where you your sword outdrawn has, and bears it naked in this place, thereof I have great wonder.
Oh, Isaac, son, peace, I pray thee. Thou breaks my heart anon in three.
I pray you, Father, like nothing from me, but tell me what you think.
Isaac, Isaac, I must thee kill.
That you will. Your own child put a spill upon this ill steep brink. If I've trespassed in any degree with your stick, you may beat me. Both your sword, if you will be, for I'm but a child.
Oh, my dear son, I am sorry to do to thee this great annoy. God's commandment do must I. It's work a rifle mild.
Is it God's will I shall be slain?
Son, I cannot hide from you. It is God's bidding I must do.
Then you must do what God has bid. But tell not me, mother, what you did.
Isaac, Isaac. Blessed must thou be. Almost my wit I lose for thee. The blood of thy body so free, I am for loath to shed.
Father, since you must needs do so, let it pass lightly and overgo. Kneeling upon my knees too, your blessing on me spread.
My blessing, dear son, give I thee, and thy mother's with heart so free. The blessing of the Trinity, my dear son, on thee light.
Pray, Father, I've my nine, that I need see not the sword so keen. You stroke, Father, I would not spy, lest I against it scream or cry.
My dear son Isaac, speak no more. Thy words make my heart full sore.
Oh, dear Father, wherefore, wherefore? Since I must needs be dead, of one thing I would you pray. Since I must die the death today, as few strokes as ye well may when ye smite off my head.
Thy meekness, John, makes me afraid. My song may be all well away.
Oh, dear Father, do away, you're making a much moan. Truly, Father, this talking doth but make long tarrying. Pray you come and make ending, and let me hence be gone.
Come hither, child.
Thou art so sweet.
Thou must be bound on hand and feet.
Father, we must no more meet, by aught that I can see. God's commandment you must fulfill, for needs so must it be. But, Father, I cry you mercy, for all that ever I have trespassed to thee. Forgive him, Father, that it may be, until doomer's day.
Oh, my dear son, let be thy moans. Blessed be thy body and bones, and I forgive thee here. Now, my dear son, here shalt thou lie. And for my work now must I hie. I had as lief myself to die as thou, my darling dear.
Father, if you be to me kind, about my head a kerchief bind, and let me lightly out of your mind, and soon that I was sped.
Now, farewell, my sweet son of grace.
I pray you, Father. Turn down my face, a little a while you have space. I'm full sore of dread.
Oh, heart, if thou should break in three, thou shalt never master me. I will no longer let for thee! My God, I may not grieve!
Mercy, Father, why tarry you so? Smite off my head and let me go. I pray you rid me of my woe, for now I take me leave.
Son, my heart will break in three to hear thee speak such words to me. Oh, Jesus, on me thou have pity. I have thee most in mind.
Now, Father, I see that I shall die. Almighty God in majesty, my soul I offer unto thee. Lord, to it be kind.
Abraham, hold back thy hand and spare to spill thine Isaac's blood. All that thy God did command thou didst obedient and good. Thy son is spared. But understand that I, mine own son, free of sin, will sacrifice to break the band the devil has all mankind within. His son hath spared him for to spill. Like his Isaac, my loved lad, shall do full heartily his father's will, and not be spared stroke sore and sad, but done to death upon a hill.
Thank you. I'll never forget the Christmas we won a turkey in the raffle. It was July before we had to feed the cat again. Luckily, Santa left me a jar of thick, creamy Hellmann's. Ooh, best Christmas ever. Gran said if Dad ate any more turkey, he'd end up looking like one. Hellmann's, don't save it for the summer.
Look at that! Everybody's after my job.
Mind you, he's got the right idea.
Yardley Gold aftershave and gift sets, that'll be a winner. And pure silk perfume sprays and gift sets.
Just what I had in mind.
I say new Yardley talc decanters, honeysuckle, roses, lily and sweet pea.
Just as well he's only a dummy.
Trust Yardley to solve your problems this Christmas.
No, oh well, thanks very much anyway. Goodbye.
Townsend.
Hello, you know the Hornby Double O Model Railway?
Yeah.
Do you have an R186 signal box?
Well, let's see. Yes, I got one left.
Great! They've got one, Mum.
Good old Yellow Pages. We're not just there for the nasty things in life, like a blocked drain or a broken window. We can help with the fun things, too.
Oh, hello, Ben.
Happy birthday, Dad.
Don't just make a cup of coffee. Create a masterpiece with Master Blend.
Mrs. Kathleen Conlon of Sunderland tells us why she feeds her cat best ever whiskers.
Marmalade always knows when it's whiskers time. And as soon as he sees the tin, he does a little dance. When I give him his whiskers, I feel close to him. He enjoys it so much, tucking into it and licking the plate clean.
That's because our nutritionists have been improving the quality of every one of Whiskers' 14 different varieties to ensure that today they're the most appetizing ever.
When he eats Whiskers, he'll sit back and he'll look up at you. And much you say, I've had a good meal and thank you.
Best ever Whiskers. In tests, 8 out of 10 owners who expressed a preference said their cats preferred it.
He's a very nice man.
He tells me jokes.
He's got puppets everywhere.
Grown-ups may find it hard to believe, but kids are now talking like this about their dentists.
I like my dentist.
Over the years, Colgate's been campaigning for one thing.
What's a cavity?
Kids without cavities.
I've never had toothache.
And great-tasting Colgate can help.
Toothache? Wouldn't like that. Oh, no.
Colgate's own unique double fluoride formulation gives the best protection a toothpaste can. Working together, we could see a lot more kids with no more cavities. So now's the time to join our dental care campaign, aiming for Colgate instead of cavities.
Isaiah says, a maiden young shall bear a son among Hebrews, that of all countries shall be king and govern all that on earth groans. Emmanuel shall be his name, to say, God's son in heaven.
My young wife is with child full great, which makes me sorrow unsought. But for certes, the child is not mine. Well, that reproof does me pine and makes me flee from home. My life, though I resign, she is a clean virgin to me without blame. But well a what, through prophecy, a maiden clean should bear a child. Yet it's not so surely, because I am beguiled. Nevertheless, it's my intent to ask her who got her bairn. That would I know where I went. All hail. God be hearing.
Welcome as God me speed. Doubtless to me is full dear. Joseph, my spouse, welcome are ye.
Gramercy, Mary, say what cheer. Tell me in sooth how is with thee. Oh, who has been there? Thy womb is waxen great. Think me thou art with child. Alas, for care, who's this, Mary?
God and yours.
Whee, why gap ye at me so and feign such fantasy? Alas, me is full woe, for though might I not die. Look to me, this is a careful case. Reckless, I rave, restless, Marina, there look no man in the face for dreadful dole. What do I dead, me lord, my life? Who's this, the child, thou art withal?
Yours, sir, and the king's of bliss.
Thou art young, and I am old. Such works, if I do, would these games from me are gone. Therefore, tell me in privity, who's this, the child, thou art with now?
Now, great God of his might, that all may dress and dight, meekly to thee I bow. Rue on this weary wight, that in his heart may light the truth to ken and know.
Who adds thy maidenhead, Mary? Hast thou aught mine?
Forsooth, I am a maiden clean.
Now thou speak'st against kind. These words from thee are wild. A maid to be with child? Such thing might no man signify. She's not born or weaned.
Joseph, ye are beguiled. With sin was I never defiled. God's sending is on me seen.
God's sending? Yeah, Mary, got it.
Angel I, that have taken Mary to my keeping and sent to thee aloud to cry, in leal wedlock lead thee, leave her not, I forbid thee, no sin of her imply, but to her fast thou speed thee, and of her naught thou dread thee, God's word this from on high. The child that shall be born of her is conceived of the Holy Ghost. All joy and bliss then shall be after, and to mankind of all the most. Jesus his name thou call, such hap shall him befall as thou shalt see in haste. His people save he shall, of evils and angers all that they are now embraced. Went forth to marry thy wife always. Bring her to Bethlehem this ilk night. There shall a child born be. God's son of heaven is he, and man I most of might.
Well, yeah, Mary, I am to blame for words that are the long since spake. But gather up now all our gear, such worn weeds as we wear, and press them in a pack. To Bethlehem I must it bear. For little things will women fear. Help up now. On me back. Fain we had some light. Oh, whatso befall, it wakes right murk unto my sight and cold withal. I will go get us light this tide, and fuel find with me to bring.
Bye.
light is this that comes shining thus suddenly?
Oh, you are welcome, sir.
Say, Mary, daughter, how is't with thee?
Right good, Joseph, as has been, eh?
Oh, Mary.
What sweet thing is that on thy knee?
It is my son, the sooth to say, that is so good.
Nah, welcome, flower fairest of hue. I shall thee marvel in main and might. Hail, my maker. Hail, Christ Jesus. Hail, royal king, root of all right. Hail, my saviour. Hail, my lord, lemur of light. Hail, blessed flower.
Of the planet, the proudliest pike, shall brace forth his beams, that our climber shall know the moon. By my might, he musters his might, and kaisers in castles great kindness to show, and lords and ladies like lovers list low. For I am fairer of face, and fresher. I hold the sooth if I shall say 7 and 6-fold than glorious ghouls that gayer is than gold in price. How think ye these tales I have told? I am worthy, witty, and wise.
My lord Herod, all kings to your crown may clearly commend your law and your lordship as lords stand on high. What traitor untrue that will not attend, ye shall lay him full low from gleam and from light, and with countenance full cruel, we shall crack here his crown.
My son!
How come this night he speaks in this case?
Father! If they like not to list to your laws as traitors untrue, you shall teach them a trade. For father, from kindness you give them no cause.
Fair fool thee, my fair son, so fairy of faith. A knight! I command whoso to dull draws these churls of jealousy chastise and chase, and dread you no doubt.
Father, I shall fell them in fine, old rogues that would leave you your right.
For I will than each wife in this world, truth to tell, that forges a felony, with force you'll be fast. Arrest ye these rivals, that unruly rebel, be they kings or knights, in care I them cast, yea, and wield them in woe with a vengeance to dwell. What brat that is boring? Brain, look ye, bah! And dig ye him down!
When God's son is born. Therefore, these lords and I all here, upon this mount we make our prayer. Devoutly once in every year, for thereto are we sworn. O Lord, what time is it thy will, Balaam's prophecy to fulfill? Give us some sign now on this hill. Lord God, leader of Israel, that thy would for mankind's heal, thou come to us and not conceal. Yea, Lord, show thy mercy on my realm rich Araby, and of thy birth now certify, here and now to thy king three.
O Lord, blessed must thou be. All my people have pity, and let us now yon star to see.
That our prayer heard is he, I believe full well by my luty, for in the star a child I see.
Lords, I read we heathen high, for I dare say and nothing lie. Fulfilled is Balaam's prophecy.
Lords, I we heathen then anon. Now we've been bidden thither gone. I will never bide by my bond till I at him be.
Sirs, our readers, every one, a dromedary to ride upon. For swifter beast there be none. One I have, ye shall see.
A dromedary in good faith will go lightly on its way, 100 miles upon a day. Such beast, now take wind.
Where is the star he went? A light away from us is glent. Witherward lies our way.
God to whom we bring present will never suffer us to be shent. That dare I boldly say.
It is good that we inquire, if any the way can us lay. Say, Bellamy that walks bad.
Can thou aught say what place or where? A child is born a crown to bear, and of the Jews be king.
We saw the star shine, veray, in the east. In noble array. Therefore now we come this way to find the palace he dwells in.
Hold your peace, sirs, I you pray, for if King Herod hear you so say, he might go mad by my fay and fly out of his skin.
Then since a great king dwells in this street, let us three lords now go him greet.
Silly farmhands that walk on moor. Your faith, we're near hands turned out the door.
No wonder, as it stands, if we be so poor, it tilth of our land lies as fallow as a floor, as you ken.
We are so unbound
of attack
and down ground, we've no rights allowed by these gentrymen.
Ah, sir, God you save and you, master mine. A drink for him would I have, and on summut to dine.
Christ curse me, lazy knave, your belly, you'll regret it.
Ah, the boy loves to rave. On any road, we've et it.
Right. By the road, these nights are long.
Get the wish, here we go.
Someone, give us a song.
Whose tups are these? Whose tups are these? Are they old jack bones? I can tell them by their horns, and I found them in the vicarage garden. Whose tups are these? Sing. Whose tups are these? Are they real jack bones? I can tell them by their horns, and I found them in the vicarage garden.
And the old jack bones, I can tell by the horns.
Whose tups are these? Are they real jack bones? I can tell them by their horns, and I found them in the vicarage garden. Tidings.
Is he come, then he can take heed of his things.
What? I dear yeoman, I tell you of the king's, the self-same one, messenger of great lordings. I shall make complaint and get you many a thwang. Without another word.
Now, Mac,
take out that southern tooth and tuck it in your turd.
Nay, lads, it's only me that knows. How goes you, and how's the earth?
Now, look out, villain. Just late as I goes, what will men suppose we've heard ill news? A sheep stealing.
And I am true, a steal. That's all men do it. But a sickness I feel that holds me full up. Me belly fares not well. Quite out of its shape.
Seldom lies the devil dead by the gate.
Therefore, full sore am I, and ill if I stand stone. Still, I ate not a needle this month and more.
Mac, how fares thee wife? But I heard, how does she do?
She lies weltering by the rood, by the fire, low, on the house full of our brood. Oh, she drinks well, too. Ill speed all other good that she ought to do. And so eats as fast as she can. And each year that comes to man, she brings forth an infant. And some years, two. Now, where are now? More gracious and richer by far. Our eating out of house and out of our birth. Oh, yeah, but there is no man trows more or knows worse than can I. Now, will you see what I proffer? To give all in my coffer at tomorrow's mass to offer a penny. Could she die?
Yeah, what's so weary with working as none in this shire? I would sleep were I taking less to me iron.
I'm cold and I'm shaking and would have a fire.
Worn out with walking and deep in the mire. Keep awake, you.
Nay, I will lie down by, for I must sleep truly.
As good a man's son was I as any of you. But Mac! Come hither. Between us, shalt thou light.
Then might I hinder the quiet words you may try, so take heed. From me top to me toe.
Toe.
Manus tuus commendo.
Toe.
Poncio Pilato.
Toe.
Christ cross me speed. That me you'll hear. I was never a shepherd, but now will I learn. Though the flock be scared, yet will I nip near. Draw hitherward. Now, mends all our cheer from sorrow. A
fat sheep, I dare say. A good fleece dare I lay. Pay back when I may. But this will I borrow.
Alas, that ever I were born. We have a foul blot. A fat wedder have we lorn.
Marry, God forbot. Now trust me, if you will, by St. Thomas of Kent. Either Mac or Jill to that give assent. Though we thither as I read and run on our feet, shall I never eat breed, the sooth till I weep.
Nor drink in my head with him till I meet.
Nor rest in no stead till that I am greet. To my lot. Jill, I had such grace.
It were a foul blot to be hanged for that case.
I wish it was slain. I list well to eat. This 12-month were not so fain for a slice of sheep meat.
Come they ere it be slain and hear the sheep bleat.
They might have been tame. That were a cold sweat. Go bar the back door.
A good jest of ice bide, since thou can find none. Here shall we him hide until they are gone. In my cradle abide, and let me alone, for I must set down beside as in childbed and groan. This were a good guise and a forecast. Still a woman's advice helps at the last.
The last word that they said, when they turn their back, they would look that they had their sheep all the pack. They'll not be well pleased when they their sheep lack.
Hearken, for when they call, they will come at once. Come and make ready all, and sing on thine own. Sing lullaby thou shalt, for I must grow and cry out by the wall on Mary and John, oh, saw. Oh.
Oh. Why, sirs, ail see ye aught but good.
Our sheep that we get is stolen as we go, our loss is great.
Some men suppose that it should be thee.
Either thee or thy spouse, so say we.
Now, if ye have supposed to Jill or to me, come, rip up an our house, then may ye see you at her. But if I any sheep got, either female or stock, Jill, my wife, rose not here since he laid her. As I am true and loyal, to God here I pray, that this be the first meal I shall eat this day.
Me middle. I pray to God so mild, if ever I ye beguiled, that I eat this child that lies in this cradle.
Peace, woman, for God's pain, and cry not so, thou spills all thy brain, and makes me full woe. I trow our sheep be slain. What find ye to?
All work we in vain, as well may we go, only tatters. I can find no flesh, hard nor nesh, salt nor fresh, only two empty platters. Living beast beside this, tame or wild, none as I had bliss tossed, long though it smelled.
No, so God give me bliss and bring me joy of my child.
You've marked amiss, I all this beguiled.
Aye, sir, we're done. If it's our lady him save, is you a child, girl or knave?
And the Lord might him have this child to his son.
Mac, friends will we be, but we're all one.
We? Now I hold back me, for amends get I none. Farewell, all three.
I'm glad we are gone.
Fair words may they be, for love is the none this year.
Gave you the child anything?
Trow not one farthing.
Fast again will I fling a viking me there. Mac, take it to no grief, I come to thy bane.
Hey, nay, thou dost me great reproof and fouls yourself born.
That child will not grieve, that little day Sam. Mac, by your leave, let me give to your bairn but sixpence.
Nay, I've done, he sleeps.
He thinks he beats.
When he wakens, he weeps. I pray you go hence.
Give me leave him to kiss and lift up the cloud. Oh.
So what the devil is this? He has a long snout.
His market amiss we should not pry about.
Ill spun weft, our wish, ever comes foul out.
Aye, so.
He's like to our sheep.
Put it, Murphy!
I trow nature will creep where it may not go.
Oh! This was a quaint gore in the forecast. This was a fine fraud.
Yes, sirs, what? Let's burn this board and bang the fast. A false call shall hang at last, so shall thou. Do you see how the swaddle is 4 feet in the middle? So I never in a cradle and on his lad here now.
He's bid out, what? Let be your uproar. I am either in gas, yon woman in bore.
Let be all that, and God send you care, I saw.
As pretty child as he, as there sat on woman's knee. A gilly done bird did cause a man love.
I know him by the ear, Mark. That is a sure token.
Tackle his hairs, ark, which his nose was broken. Then told me a clerk that witchcraft had spoken.
This was a false work. Revenge must be wroken. Get weapon.
He was taken by an elf. I saw it myself when the clock struck 12. Was he forsaken?
You two are both deaf and belong in one stead.
Since they maintain their theft, let us do them to death.
Yeah, that is Bazira. Then strike off me head. Oh, with you the matter be left.
Sir! To Marie, for this trespass, we will neither ban nor flight. Fight nor chide, I've done forthright. And set yon sheep thief in stocks and small folk on this floor. Take soaking wet sponges and splash him full sore.
I can no more, therefore will I rest.
Or to sleep anywhere? Think of this.
Now I pray you, lie down on ground.
These thieves stay still in my mind.
Wherefore should you be pined? Do as I say you.
He's coming to take and ransom you all, your sorrows to slake, King Imperial. He behests that child is born at Bethlehem this morn. Ye shall find him beformed betwixt two beasts.
Ah, God's dear Dominus, what was that song? It was
were a wonder curious small notes among. I pray to God now, save us all in this throng. I'm afeard of Jesus, summat be wrong. He thought one screamed aloud. I suppose it were a cloud. In my ear it soughed by him that be bought.
Nay, that may not be. So you certain he spoke to us three as he had been a man. When he lightened this leamy heart, shaked then. An angel was he. Tell you I can, no doubt. He spake of a burn. We must seek him, I warn.
There be tokens yon starn that stands yonder out.
It were a marvel to see, so bright as it shone. I would have trowed verily it had been thunder flown, but I saw with mine eye as I lay to this stone. It were a merry glee, such heard I never none. I record, as he said in a scream, or else that I dream, we should go to Bedlam to worship that Lord.
My Lord Herod, I met at morn three kings carping together of him that is now born, and they hight to come hither.
Three kings, forsooth?
Sir, so I say, for I saw them myself, all seer.
Examine him, we pray.
Speak, fella, are they far or near?
My lord, they will be here this day, that what I well, no doubt, is here.
Have done. Dress us in rich array, and every man make merry cheer, that no semblance may be seen, but friendship, fair and still, till we wot what they mean, whether they be fair or ill.
Sir Roy Royal and Reverend de Bougard Omnipotent.
Nous sommes venus comme plan. Nouvelles d'inquire.
Bien soit venu.
Bien soit venu.
Voyageons.
Voyageons.
Mère dit tout.
Mère dit tout.
Voter
entente.
Enfant, connais de grand parent. Et roi de Céline et d'Ité.
What? Sirs, advise you what you say. Such tidings break my heart, they may. I am the king of all mankind. I bite, I beat, I loose, I bind. Oh, master de moon! Take this in mind, that I am most of might.
Sir, I prophesy well written we that child born shall be to rule the people of Judea.
What's it to talk of prophecy? My son here soon shall see whether ye speak sooth or lie. My son, the doctor of philosophy. Look up thy books of prophesy of Daniel, David, and Isaiah, and what thou sayest. Say to me, seek each leaf, I thee pray, and what thou seest, say to me. For I dare lay all these lords, they lie. They lie. Speak in thy book. Will this boy be born for whom these lords look?
To Bethlehem, quidem terra Judah, ne qua quam minimo est in principi pus Judah. Ex te enem exitus quid rege populum meam Israel.
I will hew that harlot with my bright band so keen into pieces small. Look and search again, whether these lords shall find him in his presence attained.
Regis tacit et insula munera offeret, Request a rabbi at Sabadona a duke and summer set to a kiss of
by cock soul, thou art for so witness that be! Now all thy books are rent and torn! This realm is mine and shall be a mastery! Mastery while I may! Go forth, all kings three, and inquire if it so be. But all gates, come again to me, for thee I think to see. If he be of such degree, I will honor him as do ye, as falls to his dignity in word and thought and deed.
By your leave, sir, and have good day, till we come again this way.
Fare you well now, in good faith, but speed ye back again this way. By my hound, come there again. All three traitors shall be slain. And that swaddling swain. I will chop off his head! That boy doth me so greatly annoy that I wax dull and pure dry. I'm done! So hide away. I die, but I have a drink.
Fill fast.
And let the cups fly. Then go we, heathen, hastily, for I must ordain her curiously against these kings coming.
Loony, loony, thou little tiny child, bye bye. Tiny child, bye bye, Luli, 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 thou little tiny child, bye bye, Luli, 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 thou little tiny child, bye bye, Luli.
Comely and clean, hail, young child. Hail, maker of mean, a maiden so mild. Thou hast confounded a ween, the warlock so wild, false bringer of teen. Now goes he beguiled. Lo, merry he is. Lo, he laughs, my sweeting. A very fair meeting. I've held to me telling. Oh. Have a bob of cherries.
Hail, sovereign saviour, for thou hast to sort. Hail, nursling and flower, who all things has wrought. Hail, full of favour that makes all out of naught. Hail, a kneel and a cower.
Bed, have a broth to me bed. Hail, little tiny mop. Of our creed thou art crop, I would drink of thy cup. Little day star.
Hail, little darling dear, full of God heed. I pray you be near when that I have need. Hail, sweet in thy cheer, my heart will bleed to see thee lie here in so poor a weed with no pennies. Hail, put forth thy dole, I bring thee but a ball. Have and play we all and go to the tennis.
Father of heaven, God omnipotent, that set all in day seven his son as he sent. My name he could namen, and on me his light spent. I conceived him full even by God's might as he meant. And now he is born. May he keep you from woe. I shall pray him so. Tell forth as you go, and mind on this morn.
Farewell, lady, so fair to behold, with our child on the knee.
For he lies full cold. Lord, it is well for me. Now we go, thou behold. I hope without dread today to see that child in his array. Lord, methinks by my fear, the star it standeth still.
But it's a sign that we be near. But high ho, see I none here. To a child of such power here, this housing standeth low.
Whom seek ye, sirs, per se, so wild with talking, travelling to and fro? Here dwells a woman with a child and her husband, there are no more.
We seek a bairn whom all shall shield. A certain sign has said us so. And his mother, a maiden mild. They hope we now to find them two.
Come near, good sir, and see. Your way to an end is brought.
What present best will for him fall? Cast we here among us all. For though he lie in an ox store, his might is none the less.
Me beseemeth by this place that little treasure his mother has. Therefore, to help her in this case, gold possess shall I.
And I will offer, through God's grace, incense that noble savor has. Stink of the stable it shall make pass, where they both lie.
And myrrh is best my offering to be, to anoint him as thinks me, the baby's members head and knee, yea, all his bright body.
And moon tidings will be told tonight. Hope I will they come soon as they have height for the tell me tidings.
Nay, father, for that dance is done.
Why, whither are they gone?
Ilko one to their own land.
How sayest thou let it be?
I say, for they have passed.
What? Forth away from me?
Yea, Lord, in faithful fast, for I heard and took heed that they went all three to their own country.
Ah, dogs! The devil them speak!
Sir, more of their meaning yet well I understood. How they made offering unto that child so good that now of new is born. They say he shall be king.
Alas, then I am lorn. Fie on them, fakers, fie! Will they beguile me thus?
My lord, they did prophesy and named his name Jesus.
Thou liest, false traitor strung. Look, never thou nigh me near. On life and limb may I that faker slay.
Full high will I him hang, both thee, harlot, and him.
Hello.
Now gather in great rout your knights so sharp to strive, and bid them ding to dead all knave children they seek out,
that are of 2 years old within. In Bethlehem and all about, and search in every stead, Lord.
Spare none for your wheel.
Then shall that foundling feel full little bliss therein. With Beowulf he shall bleed.
You see right well.
What say you, sir? Let's see.
To Bethlehem must ye wend. That shrew with shame to shen. The me's the master me! Right, let me talk. And let me tell you how go work when ye come there, because ye know him not. To death there must be brought. All changing child. Within 2 year, aye. None for speech. Despair.
We do more.
Now wash forthright. Now blow up, minstrel, with all your might. The service cometh in soon.
Hey! Sit down and eat and be as merry as you can be.
Lord, at thy bidding we take our seats. Without thee will obey we thee. There is no lord of might so great throughout the world in no country in worship to abide.
I was never merrier here before than since I was first born than I am right here upon this morn. In joy I came to glide.
I heard a page make pressing of pride. All princes he passeth, he weans of posty, he weans to be worthiest of all this world wide. King over all kings, that page weaneth to be. He sent into Bethlehem to seek on every side Christ for to quell, if they might him see. But of his wicked will, the lurden, he lied. God's son doth live. There is no lord but he. Over all lords, he is king. I am death, God's messenger. Our mighty God hath sent me here too, yon lurden to slay without more ado.
Spare neither wine nor bread, for now I am king alone, so worthy as I be there none. Therefore, tonight be merry, everyone, for now my foe is dead.
When the boy sprawled at my spear end, by sitting our sire, it were a goodly sight. A good game it was, that boy, for to shend, who would be our king and put you from your right.
Yeah, it would be lovely to see those lads leap onto our spear tips and straightway to sleep.
All babes that are bawling in Bethlehem at breast, their naps know no ending, and thy realm knows rest.
Amongst all that great rout, dead he is, I have no doubt. Therefore, our minstrels round about, blow up a merry fit.
I am sent from God. Death is my name. All thing that is on ground I wield at my will, both man and beast and bird, wild and tame. When I come them to, with death I do them kill. Herb, grass, and trees strong with my dents I spill. What man that I wrestle with, he shall right soon have shame. I give him such a trip up, he shall evermore lie still. For death cannot sport. Where I smite, there is no grace. After my stroke, man hath no space to make amends for his trespass. But God him grant comfort. Oh, see how proudly yon caitiff at meat he now sits. Of death hath he no doubt. He weeneth to live forevermore. To him shall I go and give him such hits that all the leeches of the land his life shall ne'er restore. After my dreadful dents, no plea availeth yet. Afore I part him fro, I shall make him full poor. All the blood of his body I shall him outsweat. For now I go to slay him with strokes sad and sore.
I shall then make to me thrall. With my spear, slay them I shall. And so cast down his pride.
Thank you.
each one in such like array. With death he shall be dight, and closed cold in clay, whether they be king or knight. For all their garments gay that seemly were in sight, their flesh shall fret away with many a woeful wight. Thus woefully such wormy wights shall gnaw these gay knights, their lungs and their lights, their hearts shall fret in sunder, these masters most in might. Thus shall they be brought under. Your ruddiness so red, your lyre lily-like, then shall be wan as lead, and stink as dog in dyke. This space about us all, no corpse shall need as much. The roof of thy hall, thy naked nose shall touch.